Good
evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Thank you. I'm Bridget Winter. I'm the Executive Director of Young Playwrights Theater, and it is my great honor to welcome you to the third and final night of our 2017 New Play Festival. Thank you all so much for being here tonight, and a huge thank you to Anacostia Playhouse, the DC Commission on the Arts and Humanities, the National Endowment for the Arts, the City Fund, the Mayor's Office on Latino Affairs, Wells Fargo, Insomnia Cookies, hope you all had some of those in the lobby, Harris Teeter, Trader Joe's, the YPT Board of Directors, and our entire family of supporters for making the festival a reality. It has been an incredible run. At YPT, we inspire young people to realize the power of their own voices. And one of the most important ways that we do that is by bringing our students' words to life on professional stages like this one. Now, as I said, this is our third New Play Festival event this May. How many of you, by show of applause, were able to attend one of the other ones, the elementary or middle school night? Anybody? Okay. Anybody able to attend both? That is pretty fantastic. Thank you so much. As I said, this is our final performance of the New Play Festival, which is sad. But if you love what you see tonight, we do have one more performance this season on June 19th, our Young Playwrights Workshop. So I encourage you all, if you love what you see tonight, to spread the word and to make sure that those young people have a fantastic audience on June 19th at Source. So, the New Play Festival is also our annual donor appreciation event. So, by once again, round of applause. Do we have any donors in the audience tonight? Anybody, if you've ever given anything to YPT, please. Thank you. Thank you so much for coming out here to see the fruits of your gifts. YPT would not exist if not for you. And our playwrights this evening, since we can see a little bit better, could you stand? I got to see your plays in rehearsal this afternoon, and they were fantastic, so I hope you are really excited. Great. So thank you to our donors, thank you to our playwrights, thank you to our families, to our artists, to our audience members for coming out here to celebrate these young people. I think you're really going to enjoy what you see tonight. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce Farah Harris, our Creative Programs Director, to tell you a little bit more about the festival and what you're going to see.
All of this would not be possible
possible if it weren't for donors. Bridget mentioned donors. You all saw that this was a pay what you can performance. And if you feel compelled at the end of this or motivated, we will be happy to take your donations. thank you for that. And just brief housekeeping. Please make sure your phones are on vibrate or silent. If you need to exit to use the restroom, that's the door you would use if you're on this side. Just exit out of that side. Just make sure that you're aware that actors will be entering and exiting from both of those doors. We ask that you don't use professional or flash photography or videography. We have a videographer up there. We have a photographer. And that's the last I have to say. So without further ado, I will introduce our first playwright, Chase Yakalek, and he's going to talk to you about the play he wrote, Red and Cage. Thank you.
I'm in 10th grade. I currently attend Chelsea School.
Alright.
My idea where I got this from, I don't really know. It just popped up in my head. And I would give some advice when it comes to playwriting. Just like, write what you want to write, then, you know, who cares? one thing that many people don't know about me, I am dyslexic. That is a challenge I have day to day in my everyday life. If you know, little ticks here and there, but I work through it. In my free time during the afternoon, I go on social media like every other teenager. Twitter, Instagram. I don't use Facebook, I don't know who uses I feel like if I could change something about the world, I would, I don't know, I'd change world hunger, or stop it, or something like that. So thank you guys for all coming, and I hope you enjoy it. My play, Red and Cage.
He's back.
Who?
Feeding time, you ungrateful shits! Easy now, you little chubby! No one gets fed today.
Can someone please tell me what's going on? Well, is anyone going to answer me?
That was the handler.
Handler?
Yes! That's his name! He's the one that feeds us!
If we're good, something like this doesn't go unpunished. Watch yourself.
Hey, he didn't know about me.
You okay?
Oh, I'm fine.
Do you want to talk about this? You seem to be having a worse day than me, you know, waking up in a random cage and all of that.
Yeah, I'm fine. It's just rough when he comes over.
Do you mind telling me who that was?
So, that person you just saw, well, kinda like our caregiver.
He doesn't seem like he cares to me.
No. No. He's just changed his all. He used to be really nice. You see, there used to be a woman, too. She would treat us so nicely, take care of us, feed us. She used to hold me and carry me on her shoulder. The handler would smile and joke.
How come you don't carry me around on your shoulder?
And the woman laughed, saying lovingly, I would, but you're too fat. It was the best times of my life. But one day, the woman just disappeared. That's when the man became dark and cruel. He would starve us. Pour cold water on us in the winter. He used to hold us down and take our wings and rip the feathers out and
what?
He clipped me.
He what?
Didn't you hear me? He clipped my wings. I can't fly. I can't leave this place. That's why Raven and Crow stay. Don't want to leave me alone. They'd probably do better without me.
No, we wouldn't. We need you. We all need you.
No!
What?
No, I am not going to let you guys stay here. No one deserves to be treated like this. We can leave this place, all of us.
And how are we going to do that? I mean, it sounds great and all, but what is your plan?
I have an idea. But everyone has to listen to me.
Well, I'm all ears.
Come on! Don't you want to live?
I want to talk about it any longer. My grandmother raised me. Pauletta Mary Jones taught me everything I live by. Well, what I used to live by. When I hit 17, she died. 3 days after my birthday, I woke up to no smell of breakfast, no sounds of gospel music, just silence. I found my grandmother in her bed, not breathing. The crazy thing about it is that when I seen her, I did nothing but climb in the bed, sit beside her, hold her hand, and cry. While she sat there breathless, I sat there and did nothing to help. When I called the police to report it, it took them 37 minutes exactly to pull up at my house and question me about my grandmother's death like I did something. My heart always had a crack in it growing up without my parents, but the day I lost my Pauletta, it was like my heart became shattered. There really was no fixing it in my eyes. I lived 2 blocks away from the circle next door to the fine-ass Stephanie and her brother James. I never really built a friendship with them until Graham's died, but when I went to that house, it became my new home. Jake taught me how to make my own money, how to never be too friendly with too many niggas. and he just started me off the lead. But I always had my other gang on the side no one knew about. It was like a side hustle that always laid low. But man, Stephanie blessed me. The most intelligent up-and-coming woman I ever laid eyes on. She was everything to me, that head, those lips, that body. Man, she was like a young Taraji P. Henson. The love I had for that girl was real. All I think about is 3 months ago, the night I would never forget. No one was home. I came to talk to Jay, and instead of talking to Jay, I made Stephanie talk to me. I'm sorry things have to end this way. That side hustle had to be the ones to end my life. Had to be the ones to literally stab me in the back and let me bleed out. I should have seen it coming when they told me to come to their trap by myself.
But Stephanie, you were the fixin' to my heart. And the second Pauletta Mary Jones to my life.
Let's go get some food.
Yeah, where's Jay at anyway? I ain't seen him today.
Hey, pull up, hop out, see you on
my back. Hey! Oh, my God!
Stephanie, shut up!
Okay, so when I leave, you don't be hitting up, oh, she wild as shit. She ain't got to leave.
So you finally dressed before me for once, which means you wasn't on your phone all last night.
Boy, shut up, whatever.
Hey, Steph, I gotta go somewhere before we go to school, so I'ma see you in school, all
right? You going right to the circle, ain't you?
You always think you know something. Yeah, that should last you all week. Don't ask me for nothing.
Just be safe around there. I heard somebody got stabbed last night.
Bro, I ain't even know. How you know?
You know Betty Instagram logged into my phone. I seen her cousin DM'd her, and it said something about somebody being stabbed in the circle. But I ain't open it, because she didn't open it either, and it would have been marked as red, and that would have been hot.
All right, I gotta go. But make sure you hit me up after school, text me, be safe, and remember to do everything I wouldn't do. All right? Love you.
Girl, you just getting to school?
Yes, girl. I just went off this morning.
Did you hear about the boy being stabbed in the circle last night?
Yes! I seen your cousin DMing you. Do you know who it is?
No, everybody keeps saying they don't know who. Like, I know somebody knows.
Your cousin's still there around the circle?
Jail like a week ago because he had a gun charge on.
Well, at least he's home and not behind bars. That's 6 feet deep. The nurse lady just running some tests now.
Oh, okay. You want me to come in there? I'm just in class doing nothing.
I'm okay. I'm gonna text you later so we can meet up, because by the time I would be about to leave here, school will be about over.
Okay, just text me.
So, Miss Stephanie, we have found the problem.
Probably just a virus or something.
No. You're pregnant.
That can't be right.
I just ran every test that needed to be run, and you were negative for every single one except that. Have you been having sex? Was it protected? Come on, her, talk to me. That's when you have food.
It's always protected. Except for that. No.
Well, does he attend the school?
Yeah, he goes here, but I didn't see him today.
Wait, why would I faint if I was pregnant?
When you're stressed, it messes with your nervous system enough to cause you to faint. Also, with the baby, it increases your stress level even more.
Okay, so what can we do?
Well, that depends on how far along you are.
What does that even mean?
If you're over 12 weeks, you can no longer try to abort the child. I can't figure that out here, but a doctor can. Do you want me to schedule an appointment for you to see a doctor?
Okay.
If you don't mind, can I know who the young man is?
Do you know Keith?
Oh, Lord. Stephanie, new boy.
It's cool, he's new to my life, he's not.
You must not have known. I am so sorry. Keith is the young man that was stabbed last week. His aunt contacted the school. He's in the hospital. He's not doing too well. The baby's his for sure.
He's the only person I've ever been with.
Would you like me to contact his aunt?
No. But do you know what hospital he's at?
Yeah, he's at Bush Center.
Okay, can I leave?
Yeah, you may, but please let me know you're doing okay. I'm always here.
Okay, I'll let you know what the doctor said.
Girl, what happened?
So much.
Well, before you even start, just don't start crying.
I already know.
About me?
Yes.
Are you okay?
I'm really not.
Well, can we just get off of him for a minute? Girl, why'd you faint? Did you tell anything?
Yes.
Stephanie, talk to me. What's happening?
So, you remember what I told you about Keith and what we did and all that stuff?
I remember, like, yesterday.
Uh-huh, you too.
Wrong. Ugh, I remember when I did. Stephanie. Hold up.
Betty, I don't know what to do. I don't even know if he's gonna make it. I don't even know if I'm gonna make it. It's just too much to think about. I'm scared. And I don't even know what I'm gonna do about this money. Or if I even wanna keep the baby. God, my mother never tells me about anything. And now I know if I tell her about this, it's gonna be complete silence.
Have you even talked to him?
No, but still. I was thinking about going to his house, but I doubt anybody will be there. Right now, it's
probably you want to spend the night, because you don't want to leave me now.
Yeah, but can we just take a nap, because I just want to rest a little bit, and then, you know, we can do our homework, because I need to do mine.
Of course. Well, but what about college? You've always talked about it. So you don't have no idea what you want to do about this thing?
I really don't. But I do know that I'm going to talk to Nurse Izzy about seeing if I can not have this child.
Stephanie, you don't think the option of keeping it is a good idea?
In my eyes, no.
Your mother was 15 when she had James, and then turned around to a year later. You're all perfectly fine.
Betty, where is my father? He's dead, right? And why is that? Because he was in the streets so much that another man really felt the need to take his life. I cannot live like this. Knowing Keith is doing the same thing, and I'd be damned if my baby had to go through what I went through, knowing that I will never see my father again.
Hey, Steph, and I know that, but I just don't want you to do something you're gonna regret.
I understand. I just want to go to sleep.
Okay. I'm going to let you go to sleep.
You're not aborting that baby. Who's paying for it?
See, babe, this boy don't tell you about anything now.
Y'all, calm down.
Ask me for some abortion money and I'll make you regret it.
Regret it? How, James? By not giving me the money? By not paying attention to me something? You always thinking you somebody's father, but guess what? You're not. Our father is dead. Just because you have his name does not mean I will ever be your child. So you can say all that you want.
Hey, whatever you saying that name.
You're fake, Mr. Right-Ass. I hate you.
Oh, keep talking under your breath and I'm gonna forget you, my little sister. You want an abortion, right? I'm gonna give you one right here, right now.
Please, go upstairs or something.
Wait, y'all don't understand that y'all are my sisters. Y'all are my little sisters. And my biological sister just told me that she's pregnant by my man who's dead. God, what I be doing for my life to be like this?
Thank you.
cannot just act like that.
Okay, well, I'll text you something to meet up, because I gotta go somewhere. I'll text you later, okay? Hey there, Sissy.
Center right now. just like your father is in your heart. You're gonna get through this. It's gonna be okay.
Why didn't you tell me you were having sex? You know I would have understood.
Stephanie, when did you even have the time?
When did I have the time?
Mm-hmm.
When do you have the time to ever talk to me, Mom?
When are you ever even home?
You know who I had to tell?
My brother, before I could even tell my own mother. The one that's supposed to be there for me always. The one that gave birth to me doesn't even have time for a 5-minute conversation with me other than that.
Mom, have a tissue. Stephanie's decided that she wants a future without this child, and so that means that we're going to have to abort it sooner rather than later, and it does cost.
What, Stephanie? Abortion? Really?
Yes, Mom.
I'm scared. I am not built for this.
Who is? I was not built for this when I had your brother James, but I would not give or trade him for anything in the world. Neither one of y'all. Oh. I would do anything for y'all. You know this. Stephanie.
I'm sorry.
I am sorry for not listening. I'm sorry for Keith. Sorry for not even attempting to listen.
It's okay. I'm sorry for not trying myself.
But as for your son, James, he said if I was to abort this child, that he would never forgive me.
Mm.
You know how he is about family.
Mm-hmm. I knew it. He is your father's child 100%. And you know what? I bet you Keith would feel the same way. Because James is not hanging around anybody who does not have the same mindset or goals as he does.
So give me your thoughts.
I feel like doing what makes you feel right. Meaning, don't do this just thinking about yourself. Think about Keith. And think about your own family who will support you both ways. Hey, Stephanie, I know you're thinking about your future, but school is always going to be around. You got this 1 year left of high school, and then you'll be eventual high school. Just Think smart, Stephanie. It's a life decision.
Okay, well, Nurse Izzy, if I continue with what I think is best, what will I have to go through?
Well, your mom will have to call because they ask for a lot of personal information. They make you watch a clip before the papers are signed.
Okay, just send you the information.
Okay.
Okay, wait, so is this gonna hurt or something? I'm getting scared now.
No, just what you want, Stephanie. Never gonna get scared.
Stephanie, they're good doctors and they explain everything before and after the procedure. There's nothing to be scared of.
Okay.
Mom, I just sent you the information. And you should ask for Dr. Kathy.
Thank you.
Hello, Stephanie. I'm Dr. Kathy, and I'm going to be doing our procedure. I know you've been planning this for some time, and all of your tests came back fine. You are in good shape and able to do this removal. How are you feeling today?
I am feeling very nervous.
You okay?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes, Dr. Kathy.
If you weren't, would you tell me?
Of course.
When I was your age, I had so much going for me that I did not want for real. Yes, growing up for me was, I was a nerd my whole life. My family forced me to stay in the books. I practically had no social life. Yes, growing up was so much for me. I have three older sisters, and they tortured me. My life.
Dr. Chaffee?
I'm sorry. You must be her sister.
I'm her mother, but thank you for the compliment, though.
Well, I'm going to let a quick play, and I'll be back to escort you out of the room to the surgery facility.
If you are pregnant, you have three options to think about: abortion, adoption, and parenting. Consider which benefits and risks are most important to you. Absolutely no one should pressure you or trick you into making a decision you're not comfortable with. If you are considering abortion, you should know that abortion is very safe, but the risks increase the longer a pregnancy goes on. Safe, uncomplicated abortion does not cause problems for future pregnancies, such as birth defects, premature birth, or low birth weight babies, ectopic pregnancy, miscarriage, or infant death. Absolutely no one should pressure you or trick you into making a decision you're not comfortable with.
I have a
6-year-old son named Kamel King Jones. I call him King.
He has been the apple of my eye since I had him August 12, 2017 at 7:26 a.m. He was exactly 8 pounds and 5 ounces. The morning I had him and the doctors handed him over to me, all I seen was Keith's eyes and that fat nose. I loved him as soon as I laid eyes on him. I was so in love, 2 strong tears streamed down my face and I looked up at my mother with rolled eyes and couldn't hold the waterfalls from falling. Some was tears of joy, while the rest was dreams of how I wanted Keith to see his firstborn child and how my father would be even more happy than anything. I could hear Keith's voice saying, "Damn, Steph, this really is our seed, my little junior." I remember the night before I stopped hearing from him. We sat up and talked about how in the future we wanted things like this, a baby, a house, a future. But Keith, I know you're looking down and rooting me on to keep going. When I graduated school, I looked up to the sky and said, "Thank you," while rubbing my stomach. I remember hearing how I wasn't going to be able to raise King because I was still a child myself, how I wasn't going to finish school, how I didn't really want to mess up my future. I heard everything a 17-year-old could hear when she's saying she's pregnant. Some say my decision was for the people in my family. I did this because of the life I lived. We both know how it feels to grow up without a dad. We will have everything I didn't have with my mother as a child. We will build an unbreakable bond. I wanted to prove people wrong, prove to the ones who doubted me. If I aborted my child, it would be like my mother aborted me. And I knew my kid would be nothing but a blessing. I am in my second year of nursing school at the age of 23, and I am not stopping until I accomplish this. King is in love with his Uncle Jay. Sometimes I sit and thank God because Lord knows where Jay would be if he wasn't watching after King.
Life has not been the easiest, but I have been blessed to have a son who can say,
"Stephanie and Keith are my parents."
Well, at least
least in my book. But what is with all the questions, child?
You sound super sure of yourself. Look, you've done some weird stuff in the past, but this definitely takes the cake, weirdo.
Weirdo? I'll show you weirdo.
Why are you green?
I was going to kill you, me and my spiders.
I don't like you.
And you're a bitter old piece of...
Hello, my name is John. How may I help you today? Oh my God!
What, is there something wrong with my face?
Sir, you're green. Shall I call poison control?
But I will hurt you if you don't do your job and get out of my face!
Wait, don't be mean to him, Frankenstein.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Sir, can I start you both up with some drinks?
Yes, I'll have a lemonade. Oh, I'm sure he'll have some fun juice. Ah!
No, I'll have the lemonade! So why did you give me an F in your class? Because I think I'm the shit.
Well, you have great potential to be a great scientist, but you're just a little unorthodox, but in a good way, really. The real reason why I gave an F is because I think you're super smart. Smarter than me, actually. But why are you green?
Well, actually, I was making this poop, and I was making these really gigantic spiders, and we were going to kill you and your entire family, so then I spilled the crap all over me and messed up my brand new lab coat.
Oh, so you thought it was just okay to kill someone with gigantic spiders?
Yes.
Well, you are brilliant! And I guess it was wrong of me to fail you for being a great scientist. I apologize for that, it wasn't right.
Wow, do you really mean that? Man, because I'm going to feel really bad that I still have to murder you.
Wait, hold on, why? Why do I still have to die?
Well, you did give me an F.
Thank you.
When I was 10 years old, I told my mother that I wanted to be an actress.
When I was 10 years old, I got the lead in the school play.
She told me that there are no Asians in Hollywood.
My parents got me a big bouquet with pink and red flowers.
I cried.
I smiled.
My father apologized, but he told me the same thing.
We went out for a celebratory dinner afterwards.
That was a long time ago.
Auditioned for a lifetime in the spotlight.
Do you need any help?
I don't think you could help much.
Well, maybe Mom can't, but I've been in this country for 25 years.
That's only a few more than me.
Well, most parents have been here their entire lives.
What's the matter, May May?
I'm fine. Is it school or distress?
Because if you need help in math again, I can help you.
A talent agency is coming to my school in a few weeks.
Huh.
Why?
Our school is basically an art school. They're looking for people to sign.
Well, isn't that what you want?
Yes. No, it's complicated.
Well, what do you need to do?
Well, on the 29th, they're having audition-type interviews. It's open to anyone 15 and older.
Well, you're 16.
I know.
So you could do it.
Why would she want to?
What do you mean?
School plays. Is that not enough?
No, it's not, Mom. I want to do this for longer.
Don't be ridiculous.
Why don't we talk about this?
No, we do not need to talk again. We do it every time she wants to audition or sign up for theater class. We've had the same talk over and over. I'm tired.
What is so wrong with that? What is so wrong with wanting to act?
Everything. You're not made for this, Maylin. You never have been. We Chinese people, you do not see us in movies unless it's in China. And the same goes for every other Asian person.
What? You think you have a chance in Hollywood?
They will take one look at your eyes and your hair and they will turn you away. You are hoping for a dream that will never come true. It is childish. You need to give it up now.
I have to finish this.
Maylin.
Good night.
That was not necessary.
We both know that it was.
He's very hurt.
She will be even more hurt if she continues on. It would be so much easier if she just does as she is told. You should not be encouraging this.
I'm not. But I won't keep her from it either.
I only want the best for her.
We both do.
How are we supposed to guide her in this? Huh? School, yes. College, yes. Jobs, yes. But this? What can we do in this?
You are right when you say that. That's all we can do. Support her as much as we can.
She's not good for acting. For Hollywood, she is much too self-conscious, too unsure of herself. If she were ambitious, well, that may be a different story. But Maylin?
Maylin has hope. And that, I think, is enough for ambition to grow from.
You're Maylin, right?
Yes.
was wondering if you could help me with math homework. See, I get the concepts, but like trying to execute them is when I fail.
Well, I don't see why you're asking me. I'm no good either.
Oh. Well, maybe we could still work on it together.
Sure, but I don't really see why you want to. I'd probably just slow you down.
That's cool. We can be slow together. I'm Eric, by the way.
Nice to meet you. Do you have a free period right now?
Actually, yeah. Library work for you?
Sure.
Awesome.
Okay. So stupid.
I never thought.
I'm in the ensemble.
I'm the lead.
Again. It'll never change, will it?
It'll always be the same.
Hoping for a dream that'll never come true.
Perfect starlit material.
Childish.
Talented.
What
makes me so different?
Hey, Jacqueline. Congrats on getting
the lead. Oh, thanks. Are you coming to rehearsal?
No.
Why?
I dropped out.
What? Why?
Conflicts.
Are you okay?
Why?
You just seem a little out of it.
I'm fine, but thanks.
It's just one show.
It's always the same.
It's not fair.
Like you?
No. You're still doing the talent agency thing, right?
I don't know.
Well, you totally should.
Oh, I don't really know what to expect.
Look, I've got a free period right now. Just talk to me about what's up. You're upset, and I know it.
That's really nice of you and all, but...
Do you want to know something? I heard you sing during auditions. A window was open when I was practicing outside, and I had never heard somebody our age give a song with so much feeling without, like, losing track of her vocals. I've seen, like, 5 Broadway shows, and I am being honest when I say that you have that quality. I was so stunned that I ran inside to see who could possibly be doing that, and when you walked out, I was speechless.
That's really kind of you.
And I am being 100% honest. I swear to God, I have no idea why no one's cast you yet in a big role. We only have 2 classes together, and that's theater and chorus, which is kind of unfortunate because you seem like a really nice person. Thanks. Anyway, I don't think you should give up so fast.
Who said I was giving up?
Nobody, but you look like you're about to, and you shouldn't. Because this is a small town, and a small school, and you can't let high school experiences affect your passion.
Did you practice that?
In the shower?
Been thinking about it a lot. Well, that's just, wow. Are you doing the talent agency thing?
Of course.
I guess we'll give it a try.
Ah, great!
I don't think we've ever formally introduced ourselves. I'm Maylin.
Jacqueline.
So bad at this. Guess you were just being modest. Say, do you understand science homework in any way?
Oh yeah, I really like science, so it's a pretty easy subject for me.
Cool. Explain this to me. Hey, Jacqueline.
Hey, Eric.
Hi.
Oh, hi. How are you?
I'm pretty good. Just helping Eric with his homework.
You're in my science class. Think you can explain this to me? You could take your time, of course.
Wasn't she just helping you?
You don't mind, do you?
No, I'm No. Actually, I can't stay very long. I have a rehearsal.
Okay.
See you around.
My favorite.
Fine.
What your mother said the other day was mean.
It was honest.
It's what Chinese people are.
That's true.
She just wants you to have a happy future.
You mean one as a doctor?
Well, that would be nice, but I don't think that's what you want.
Nope. What I want is wrong.
But you can't help that, hmm?
No. I don't think you guys understand.
Understand what?
How hard I fight.
Fight? What are you fighting exactly, huh? The theater?
Yes. No. In a way, you see, Dad, it's just, I am not the kind of person you see in movies or plays, at least not often. Every time I audition, it is a fight. I am fighting for people to see me, not just my race or my face.
I see.
Do you understand?
I do. Your mother and I both do. But I guess she just does not see all the point in all the fighting. But I think I can.
Is she mad at me?
No.
She won't talk to me.
And that's because you won't talk to her.
Well, I don't know what to talk about.
What? What happened to the little girl who couldn't stop talking once she got started, huh?
Different now.
I suppose you're right. It's not bad, but sometimes I do miss the little one every now and then. Your mother and I want you to be happy when you are older. With a good job, a good house, and maybe good husband. We do not want to see you getting rejected again and again, or cast aside into roles that do not matter. We want you to be well-fed and secure. Being an actor is a hard life. Cold life, as my father would have said.
I know that, Dad, but what if I can change that?
Many have tried already, Maymay.
Maybe I can pave the way. Maybe I can be the one that makes it easier for people like us.
Be the change that you wish to see in the world.
Gandhi?
I'm more educated than you might think.
Can you sign this?
Father may think otherwise, but I know Jacqueline.
You are not naive. You know your value. You know your worth. You wouldn't let people take advantage of you.
But what if I didn't?
Well, then obviously I'd have to give you a lesson or two.
Well, it's a difficult world, Hollywood.
Oh, but you shouldn't let that discourage you. Have I ever told you my boutique story?
No, 1,000 times.
Well, this time, you really need to listen. I was the oldest of 4 kids, Jackie. Growing up on a farm isn't as romantic as you think. You're always smelling like cow manure or some other animal's excrement. Going to school meant a 40-minute bus ride. Pretty early on, my parents knew I'd get the standard education, nothing more than high school. I didn't like that. No. And so I worked my butt off. Where I met Dad at that college, 4 or 5 years later, we moved here, to this seemingly big town.
And then you got married and opened up the boutique. He's always away on business, but you can't get everything. So
we got married. Planned for a year and a half before opening up my business. I fought person after person to make my dream come true. Dreams, they're lovely things, but they don't come true overnight. You have to work for them. Whether you want to be an esteemed surgeon or an Oscar winning actress, you have to work, 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 work.
I just want to act. That's all I want. But I can't because of people like my parents and Jacqueline and you, you stupid line! You will always be there, won't you? No matter what I do, you will always be there. I don't want to be what everyone expects. I don't want to be a doctor or a lawyer or whatever. I don't want to give up.
Hey, Lynn, you don't have to give up. You don't have to. It's not fair. I know. No, I'm sorry.
You're sorry?
I don't know what else to say or tell you.
Go on, then say it.
I think this line is stupid too! You know? but I don't think it's gonna go away anytime soon. It used to be wider, I think, but even then it's taken years for it to get this thin, and it's still pretty thick. But I think times are changing. I mean, so much has happened in the past couple of years, people winning awards in movies. I think patience is gonna be key. And I know, it's ironic for me to be telling you this, but I don't think you're gonna hear it at home. So I'm gonna tell you. This line is present. We both know that. But you don't have to let it bother you as much as you're letting it. You don't have to let it win right away. Hey, Lynn, you can fight. You can fight for people like you. You can fight against this line, and it's not gonna be easy, I think, but when you want something, it never is. And you don't have to do it alone.
I don't?
God, no. This isn't just your fight either. The people who have the luxury of ease on this line, they should help too.
Does that mean you?
Yeah. Yeah, it means me.
Thank you.
Chinese in America, They expect you to only be so-and-so. Not this. It is much easier if you just be what they want you to be, because all those doors are already open for you.
I know that, Mom. I always have.
I just want you to be happy.
I know that too. I just wanted to say that I'm sorry. It was really rude and mean. And
hey, I can understand where all that stuff is coming from. It seems that hanging out with you has really opened up my eyes.
Maylin, who is this?
Oh, Mom. This is Jacqueline. She's a friend.
Hi! Nice to meet you.
I'm really nervous.
To meet you. Don't be, you're amazing.
Thanks.
We're ready for you.
There. Go! Represent us!
So, tell me a little bit about your experience with acting.
Well, I've been in 6 shows in all, 3 of them musicals.
Were they all full conducted?
Yes.
Do you have any special talents you'd like to tell me about?
Dance, singing. Well, yes. I've been told I have Broadway quality singing. Interesting.
Milan, pretty name.
Thank you.
How do you say your last name? Huang.
It's spelled H-U-A-N-G, but it's pronounced Huang.
It's very...
Chinese.
Oh, so that's what you are.
Is there anything you'd like me to read?
Actually, yes. Try this.
The man came in the night. I was comforting Kenji from a nightmare when I heard the door to our bedroom being opened. I tried to listen in on the voices, but the conversation was too hushed. The door to our bedroom opened, and there stood Mother, still in her nightgown, hair rolled up in rags. She told us that we had to get our suitcases. And although the words were so simple, it's like someone pulled me from behind and I was falling. Father had told us that we had to be prepared at any second to move, but I never thought it would actually happen. I never thought we'd end up like the Yukimuras or the Ashidas, people accused of treason or spying. I never thought we'd be one of those nice Japanese families that just disappeared overnight. I guess I was wrong.
That was very good.
Really? That was written for a Japanese girl.
Yes, it was. They're developing a new historic television series that focuses on World War II told from different viewpoints.
And fortunately for you, they're filming in this general area. But I'm not Japanese.
That doesn't matter. Just as long as you look and act the part.
Okay?
I'll be emailing you more information. Silver Screen will be very pleased to have you as one of its clients.
So I'm in?
Of course. Normally we don't go for, you know, people like you, but there's some potential I'm sensing. Is there a body rubber?
My mother is.
How convenient. Sandorin will have everything signed.
Oh, yes, of course.
Maylin and I were the only actors to be signed from our entire region.
Oh, it still doesn't feel real.
There's a lot of legal stuff involved because we're still minors.
My prom night. My parents want me to wait until I'm at least 18.
The agent told us that just because we're signed doesn't mean we'll be stars right away.
I know it'll be harder for me than most.
I understand the work that is to come.
My mother once said that my chances are as thin as paper.
My mother once told me I was practically made for this.
But I'm not alone.
No.